Hi friends, we have learned a lot about circles and we started this journey with one of our simplest video on terms related to a circle with an example of park. I hope you guys remember that. We did learn a few theorems too. We all love going to a party. So there was an amazing party at the top floor of a twin building. Now these buildings were separated by a road and had an entrance exactly in front of each other. Now in order to get the top floor, there were lifts which were exactly in the center of these buildings. The party planners wanted to make a bridge connecting both the top floors, and the easiest way was to make a bridge connecting the lifts. Now this bridge needs to be perfectly straight. So can you guys think of something? Is there anything that can you guys observe? Here we can see that there are two circles which are touching at one point. Well, we did learn something about a line that touches the circle at one point. Do you remember anything about that? Yes, we are talking about a tangent. So, when we have two circles touching at one point, they are called as tangent circles or touching circles. And the common point is called as point of contact. Now, touching circles can be of two types. Either they can be externally touching circles or they can be internally touching circles. Here in this session, we will be majorly learning about the relationship between the point of contact and the centers of these circles. Here we will try to make a bridge from the center of the circles. Then will it be straight? I mean, on the paper, it looks like that it will be straight. But just because it is looking straight on paper, that does not mean it will be straight. So we need 100% accurate proof for this. And when we need proofs, geometry comes to our rescue. Now what we need to prove is that the radius of both the circles and the point at which the circle intersects are in the same line. That is, they are collinear. So let's consider two circles with the center A and B touching at a common point C. So here we need to prove that the point C lies on the line AB. So in order to prove this, we are going to take the help of the road which was passing through the center of buildings. Correct? So we will name the road as line PQ, which passes through only point C. And then we can join AC and BC. If we notice that the line PQ is nothing but tangent to the circle with center A, and it is also a tangent to the circle with the center B. Now we know that when a radius is drawn from the center of the circle to the tangent, the radius is perpendicular to the tangent, which means that the angle ACP is equal to 90 degrees. And similarly, we can say that angle BCP will also be equal to 90 degrees. Now, when we add both these angles, that is angle ACP and angle BCP, their addition will be 180 degrees. Now, we know that when the measure of two angles is 180 degrees, they are called as linear pair of angles, where linear means a straight line. So, we can say that the points A, C and B lie on the same line, or they are collinear points. So, here this satisfies the party planners that the bridge will be 100% straight, and they went ahead and had a great party. But this is true in the case of externally touching circles. Then what about the internally touching circles? Well, that too is very simple. Now we know that AC will be perpendicular to the line PQ and BC will also be perpendicular to line PQ. But if AC and BC are perpendicular to the same line and on the same point, then it has to be the same line. Correct? Well, let's try to do this once again. Let's take a line, and on this point, if I'm drawing a perpendicular, then from this point, there will be only one line which will be exactly perpendicular to this line. So, even after trying various possibilities, it is not possible that there can be any other line which can be perpendicular to this line on the same point. So, here we have learned that in externally touching circles and in internally touching circles, the radii and the point of contact will be collinear. Now, let's see a few examples that how we can use these concepts in solving certain questions. Three congruent circles with center P, Q and R with radius 6 cm touch each other externally at points A, B and C. Now, using their centers, a triangle was made. Now, in here, we have to find the perimeter of the triangle and the length of AB, BC and AC. Now, since we have just learned that point P, A and Q will be collinear, so this will be one side of the triangle, and in the similar way, QR will be the other side and PR will be the third side of the triangle. What exactly perimeter means? Perimeter is nothing but the addition of all the three sides of the triangle, right? Now, in order to find the length of PQ, we need to add PA plus QA. Whereas PA and QA are nothing but the radii of the circles, and we know the measure of them, which is 6 cm. So the measure of PQ comes as 12 cm. And in the similar way, we can find the measure of QR and the measure of PR. Now, by adding the measure of PQ, QR and PR, we will get the length of the perimeter of the triangle, which is nothing but 36 centimeters. Now, what we have to do is find the length of AB. Now, if we have a look at this particular triangle PQR, point A is the midpoint of the side PQ and point B is the midpoint of the side QR. Now, can you remember one of the theorem which will remind you something from the word midpoint? Yes, I am talking about the midpoint theorem. And what does the theorem says? It says that when a line is made using the midpoints of the two sides of the triangle, that line is half of the length of the third side of the triangle. Correct? So in here, the measure of the third side, that is PR, is 12 cm. So the length of AB will be nothing but half of PR, that is 6 cm. Correct? Now in the similar manner, we can find the measure of BC and AC. Here we are done with our first problem. Now, let's have a look at the second problem. Well, I won't be solving this entire problem, but I'll just give you an overview and I'm sure you can solve it by your own. Now, in this given figure, there are two externally touching circles with the centers as P and Q, which are touching at a point R. We know the length of PS and we know the length of QT. Now, we need to find the length of PT and we need to find the length of SQ. Now, as we join PS and QT, we can see that certain triangles are formed, correct? And PS is the radius and QS is nothing, the tangent to the circle with the center P, correct? So when we have a radius on a tangent at the point of contact, the radius is nothing but perpendicular to the tangent, which means the triangle PSQ is a right angle triangle. And in here, we know the length of PS. PS is nothing but 5 cm. And the length of PQ can be very easily found out. It is nothing but PR plus RQ, which is nothing but 5 cm plus 8 cm, which is equal to 13 cm. Now we have two sides. Now using Pythagoras' theorem, you can find the measure of the third side of the triangle. And in the similar manner, you can find the length of PT also. I hope you like our video. You can also buy our courses in the form of DVDs, pen drives and online courses, which are available on different platforms. All links are given in the description box below. Press that bell icon and turn your notifications on. And also, please do not forget to like, comment, share and subscribe.